Welcome to Church Online. I'm Linda Hopwood, pastor of Ives Chapel United Methodist Church. We continue to gather remotely for worship as our way to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. Today is Palm and Passion Sunday, April 5th, 2020. This is a day when we wave palms and celebrate Jesus as our King. Celebrate now as you listen to or sing hymn number 280, All Glory, Laud, and Honor. Join me in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We continue to learn who God is by looking at the I Am sayings of Jesus. Our scripture this morning is from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 7. Hear these words. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. May God add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and understanding of this word. This is Palm and Passion Sunday. This is a day when we celebrate Jesus' triumphal procession through Jerusalem, with people waving palms and hailing him as King. We also remember that the mood of the crowd changes quickly. And in less than a week,
Jesus is put to death on a cross. In John chapter 12, verses 12 and 13, we learn about Jesus' entrance into Jerusalem. Here's how the New Living Translation describes it. The news that Jesus was on the way to Jerusalem swept through the city. A large crowd of Passover visitors took palm branches and went down the road to meet him. They shouted, "Praise God! Blessings on the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hail to the King of Israel!" In the time of Jesus, a king enters cities by riding a war horse to signal his military power. This was especially true if he enters a recently conquered city where his rule may be called into question. The exception to this custom was when a beloved king enters his own capital city. Then he rides a donkey, showing the people he is their benevolent king. The prophet Zechariah prophesies of the day Jerusalem sees the return of her king. Because they know this prophecy, the people shout Hosanna and wave palm branches when Jesus enters the city. And yet, some of these same people turn into an angry mob in a few days and shout for Jesus' blood, yelling he should be crucified. The true vine, who also is the true king, returns to Jerusalem knowing that her people will betray him. Even so, he mounts a donkey instead of a war horse and enters the city in peace. Since we know the rest of the story, we know Jesus wins the ultimate victory for the very people who do betray him. Jesus submits himself to their violence and to our violence. Even though we're jumping ahead of today's story, we know Jesus confirms our guilt and yet achieves our forgiveness in one decisive victory through the cross. All of this is background for today's I Am Saying. Throughout Lent, we've used the study called The God We Can Know by Rob Fuquay to learn more about who God is by looking at the I Am descriptions of Jesus found in the Gospel of John. God really wants us to know God. So much so that God sends us Jesus to show us firsthand how we should live and how we should love God. Today's statement is, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Now that statement seems pretty clear forward. It's the next sentence that makes us pause. "No one comes to the Father except through me," Jesus tells his disciples. There are many scripture passages that can make us deeply uncomfortable, and this passage ranks right up on that list. In the Western world in the last two centuries or so, this passage has become a sort of gotcha scripture. In our independent, self-sufficient culture, we struggle with the idea that Jesus is the only way. Bible scholar N.T. Wright says there are professing Christians who make rejecting the uniqueness of who Jesus is central to their faith. The problem with this, though, is it doesn't work. it says this: if you dethrone Jesus, you enthrone something or someone else instead. While many Christians and churches have been arrogant in the way they've addressed this scripture, claiming that their presentation of Jesus is the only way, the whole New Testament tells us that the one true living God is the God of Israel. And even more than that, the God of Israel has acted decisively through Jesus to bring Israel's story to a proper direction and to rescue the world. Today's saying comes at the end of Jesus' Last Supper with his disciples. While other I Am sayings have been directed to large crowds or to the religious leaders, this is shared with those who should know Jesus best. He's just imparted the difficult news that the end of his life is coming soon. He tries to reassure his disciples that despite the trauma they are about to endure, everything will turn out okay. "You know the way to the place where I am going," he tells them. Now the disciples are likely bewildered by this statement, but only one of them is honest enough to admit he just doesn't get it. While he's sometimes referred to as Doubting Thomas, I think it's more that Thomas really wants to understand. And he's willing to ask questions when he's trying to figure something out. "No, we don't know the way," Thomas says with his typical bluntness. "I am the way, the truth, and the life," Jesus assures him and the others. Even as that has meaning for us, this statement has extraordinary meaning for his Jewish followers. In one sentence, Jesus takes three basic concepts of Judaism and says that in him, these three concepts have been realized. The idea of the ways of God and the ways people must walk to follow God is foundational to Judaism. There are references about how people are to walk with God found throughout the Old Testament. And yet, the people of Israel are not following these passages. Jesus doesn't just give them or us advice and directions on how we should live. He leads us. He strengthens us and guides us. He shows us the way we are to go. There's a story told of a missionary who wants to reach a remote village in Central America. He goes to the nearest town and hires a guide. They walk down a road. The road gradually narrows to a path, and eventually, even the path disappears. The guide takes out a machete and starts to hack a path through the jungle. After several hours of fighting the dense foliage and making slow progress, the missionary is exhausted and discouraged. "Are you sure this is the way?" he asks. "I am the way," the guide replies. "Follow me." Jesus is the way. Follow him. Jesus also is the truth. 77 times in the four Gospels, Jesus begins a statement by saying, "I tell you the truth." He tells the truth because he is the author of truth. And Jesus doesn't just tell us about the truth. He embodies the truth. And he is the author of life. When it comes down to it, all of us want lives that are worth living. We may seek our worth by trying to find the right occupation, the right mate, or any one of dozens of other things we can use as a source of our identity. Instead, what we need is Jesus. Those who follow him and trust his word find abundant and eternal life. Those who follow anyone or anything else do not. When Jesus says, "I am the way and the truth and the life," these words are one of his big identity statements. Without adding any other qualifications, he declares himself as the way, truth, and life. God is accessible through Jesus because Jesus is God. These words are a gift. With Jesus, we have the deepest personal security in life, knowing that all can be found in him. Jesus brings inner peace. Even in the face of his impending death and what the disciples will have to endure in the world, he does not want their hearts to be troubled. Jesus wants them to be at peace because he will not abandon them. He does not abandon us either. He is the way. Where he goes, we follow. He is the truth. All other claims to truth are measured by him. He is the life. We have true life in us, the spring of water welling up into everlasting life through him. That's why Jesus can say that no one comes to the Father except through him. He is not speaking to outsiders here, but reminding his disciples of their commitment to him. Some preachers like to quote that line to make you think you have to follow them or their church exclusively. These are people it's good to ignore. Christ is Lord of all, not just a few. Follow him. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. I would invite you to continue in a spirit of worship as you listen to or sing along with the song, "Give Me Jesus," an African-American spiritual recorded by Jeremy Camp.
Just give me Jesus. come to die when I come to die. Oh, when I come to die, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world. Just give me Jesus. Give me Jesus.
Your financial contributions to Ives Chapel enable us to continue to demonstrate that Jesus shows us the way we are to live. Thank you for continuing to support Ives Chapel financially by mailing your contributions to Post Office Box 157. Plan to join in a Good Friday time of reflection as we walk through the Way of the Cross at 7 p.m. Friday, April 10th. Check this coming Wednesday's email for details on how you can join this service. Now go with this blessing. Jesus shows us the way, the truth, and the life. Show His ways to others. Speak truth that is encouraging. And give life to others by sharing the message of God's love. Amen.